Hi everyone, let's begin our concept of effect size, because number of the researchers, they usually does not report effect size, only significance level, power, and type 1, type 2 error they are reporting, but effect size they are not reporting. So effect size, if you are reporting, definitely it gives you, your paper importance that would increase. And this one is the effect size. If we talk about effect size, is magnitude of the difference between groups. There are the, let's say we have two groups. So what is the magnitude difference, right, in between these two groups? Earlier, if we are not reporting effect size, so we are simply reflecting, suppose we are applying t-test, we are applying z-test. So in the t-test, simply we are saying this is the difference between these two groups. But we are not explaining what is the magnitude of this difference. So absolute size is the difference between the average outcomes of two different intervention groups. And effect size is a quantitative measure of the magnitude of the experimental effect. And we believe larger the effect size, stronger effect size, stronger the relationship between the groups, and smaller the probability of making type 2 error. And calculate by taking difference between means of one group and another group, then divided by the standard deviation of one of the group, that how we have to calculate effect size. And it helps in determining sample size for future studies also. So now, before starting this, I would like to explain you, first of all, what is the difference between type 1, type 2 error? We can see here, type 1, type 2 error, null hypothesis is true, right? And when we are accepting null hypothesis, and when we are, there's two categories, when we are rejecting null hypothesis. When null hypothesis is true and we are accepting, that is the correct decision. There is no ambiguity. But when our null hypothesis is true, but still we are rejecting this hypothesis. So this kind of error, we are calling it type 1 error, or we can call it alpha error. Right? And when the null hypothesis is false, but still we are accepting this hypothesis, so this type of error, we are calling it type 2 error, or we are calling it beta error. But when null hypothesis is false, right, and we are rejecting this hypothesis, that is our correct decision. So out of these two types of type 1, type 2 error, which one is the more dangerous? Type 2 error is more dangerous because something is wrong and we are accepting it. Right. Let's say we had framed some hypothesis, and for the corona vaccination, we people are saying this vaccination, this particular drug is effective in corona, but that is false. So ultimately, what would happen? We will lose some more people, right? Just because of on the basis of our false hypothesis, we had accepted null. This one is the null, false hypothesis, and we had accepted, and this kind of error is more dangerous. So type 2 error, that is the beta error. We are calling it beta error. Now we come to the power analysis. So sample size, we have to first understand this is the decision between Cohen's first time, because Cohen's he had studied a lot on this effect size. So here is, I would like to explain you this formula and how we have to calculate, how we have to determine this Cohen's d effect size. So sample size, I had already explained you in my previous video. I would share this link also in this video. And effect size, we are going to calculate in this video. Significance level, you understand, and power, we will discuss. Effect size calculation, Cohen's D equal to x bar minus x bar 2. That means, and it is divided by standard deviation. X1 is experimental group, X2 is control group. So what we have to do, from experimental group, we will minus control group. And when standard deviation is equal to each other, S1 equal to S2, so we will simply put it, this is standard deviation, then we can get this Cohen's D, that is your effect size. But when your S1 is not equal to S2, means the standard deviation of one sample is not equal to, right, another one. So here is, we have to take standard deviation average value. So S1 plus S2 divided by 2, whatever is the output will come out, and we have to put in this formula. Next, we come to the power. I was talking about power. Power is correctly rejecting the false null hypothesis. Power is 1 minus beta. As you said, beta is type 2 error. So power is 1 minus beta. So now power is probability of correctly rejecting false null hypothesis. So our interest to increase power. So ultimately what we have to do, we would like to increase power because that means we are correctly rejecting false null hypothesis. There are many ways to increase the power. Increase the sample size or increase the alpha value. There are so many ways through which you can improve your, this one is the power. First, you have to increase the sample size. Then there would be probability of correctly rejecting the false null hypothesis or increase the alpha level. So here is how to improve the power. As I said, relax alpha value, right, 0.0121, right? You can increase this. Increase the reliability of measure also and increase the sample size. You can see here, statistical power, effect size and sample size. All three things are very, very important when you are reporting with sample size. So because number of viewers, they said when I had uploaded sample size video, then they said, ma'am, kindly prepare a video on effect size. How we could be able to calculate effect size and what is the relevance of effect size with our research. So effect size is how you have to determine. A commonly used interpretation is to refer to effect size as small, right? If D equal to 0.2. If after calculation your value is equal to 0.2, that means your effect size is small. But when your calculated value, effect size is equal to 0.5, that means it is medium. And when it is greater than 0.8, that means it is large, based on your benchmark suggested by the Cohen's in 1988. As the effect size increases, the power of a statistical test increases, right? As your effect size increases, the power of statistical test is also increases. The effect size D is defined as the number of the standard deviation between the null mean and the alternate mean. A large effect means that a research finding has practical significance, while a small effect size indicates limited practical applications, right? So here is, I'm sure, large effect size and small effect size, you understand. If we calculate R square equal to 0.2, means model explains 20% of total variance in the model. So mean difference in ANOVA use eta. Here is definitely we are going to calculate effect size for ANOVA also. And 0.01 is small, 0.06 is medium, 0.14 is large, as I had mentioned earlier also. And effect size, basically, it indicates how much change in dependent variable explained by independent variable. So like when we are calculating sample size, same way we must find out effect size also. So then this value would be helpful to us whether effect size, how much changes in the dependent variable explained by our independent variable, right? I hope this video would be helpful to you, and I'm sure you will apply in your research work apart from your sample size. And that would be, I'm sure you could be able to calculate easily with the help of this formula. Keep watching. Thank you so much.